Hey kids, welcome to week 3 of Playdate. Man, I'm super excited for this week as it is probably one of the hardest things to do. I don't know about you, but our big idea this week is step 3, listen to God. I don't know about you, but sometimes I forget to listen a lot. I get distracted, maybe playing my games or a video game or different things like that. And I hear it, but I don't respond to what people are saying. In the same way, we're going to learn today about a prophet that heard God's voice and responded the way that we should respond. You know, like we talked last week, God's voice isn't something that is like this big booming voice. Sometimes it comes through prayer. It also comes through God's word. It also comes in a lot of different ways. But this week, we're going to learn one of the ways that God can speak to us, and that is through his word. I don't know about you, but I'm excited to talk about how we can listen to God, not only through his word, but listen to his voice. So before we dive in, let's pray and let's ask God to be with us. Here we go. God, we love you and we thank you. I thank you that we can listen to you no matter what, no matter where, or no matter what's going on. And God, I pray that you would speak to us and that we would listen this time. God, don't allow us to be distracted or hear it and not respond like sometimes we do when we get distracted with other things. God, I pray that you would allow us to listen to you today. We love you and we thank you. And in your name, amen. Well, hey, let's dive into our teaching video as we find out how we can listen to God. Let's go.
Well, good news, folks. Over the past couple weeks, we now have over 2,000 subscribers on my new cooking channel. Isn't that exciting? So, in honor of this special occasion, I wanted to create a very special treat for you guys. Want to know what it is? Are you ready? Drum roll. A rando sando, AKA a random sandwich. Yes, the famous sandwich that is filled with random stuff. We will take a ton of ingredients that don't belong together, put them in one sandwich, and then we'll try it. I do have one twist though. All the ingredients will be coming from what you guys comment. Isn't that exciting? I'm not scared at all. So go ahead, comment below what you think I should put in my sandwich. All right, go for it, guys. Whoa, bread. Oh, wow, That's surprising. You put bread on a sandwich. Done, my dude. Whoa, a snack cake. All right, I got one right here, so we're gonna put that right on there. Ketchup. Oh, all right, if you say so, I guess I have to listen to you. Oh man, that's gnarly. Sick. And the last ingredient, let's see what it is. A banana. Cool. There we are. Yay. All right, it serves up. Yum, so good. It's like, wow, that is really good. Excuse me one second. And I'm back. Kids, I'm not sure that was the best idea.
Hey Cooper, what was the best idea?
No, I said I wasn't sure if it was the best idea. I just ate the world's worst sandwich because they told me to. Check it out.
Oh, that looks gross. Why did you listen to them if you knew it would make you sick?
I have to listen. Isn't that step number 3 in your super duper recipe book?
Well, not entirely. Can you read it again?
Fine, I'll read it again if it makes you feel better. See, here, step 3, here, listen.
Listen to who?
Whoa, God?
There it is. You see, when it comes to eating nasty foods, we don't always have to listen. But when God speaks, that's when we should stop and listen.
Like Samuel.
Hey, you read the story.
Of course I did. Well, most of it. Some of it. Okay, fine. Just the last verses.
Oh, well, let's talk about the beginning then. You remember last week when Hannah prayed to God for a baby?
Yeah, who could forget? It was a wonderful story about how we need to talk to God.
Right. Well, Hannah had her baby boy and she named him Samuel. Samuel grew up in the temple and was taught by Eli the priest. And one night, Samuel woke up to his name being called.
Oh, Samuel is in trouble, my dudes.
Samuel ran into Eli's room and said, "Here I am, you called me." Eli was confused because he didn't call Samuel. Eli sent him back to bed, but this happened 2 more times.
What in the world? Who is calling Samuel?
Well, that's what Eli and Samuel were both wondering. But then Eli realized what was going on. So Eli told Samuel to go back to bed, and if he hears his name being called again, then he should say these words. "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening."
Wow. "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." That's powerful, man. But what does that mean?
Don't you see? Eli wasn't calling Samuel. No one was in the temple. So the only one who could be calling Samuel that moment had to be...
God! That's huge.
Isn't it? From then on, Samuel listened to God and spread the message of God to everyone he knew.
How cool is that? So God really does speak to us.
Of course, we may not hear God's voice like you're hearing my voice right now, but God speaks through many ways.
Really? Like what?
Well, we can hear from God in a bunch of different ways. Let's say you're going for a walk. God can show you things just by looking around outside in nature. Or if you're reading the Bible, God can talk to you through those words. Sometimes having a conversation with somebody who loves God helps us hear from God too. The stories in the Old Testament talk about people hearing from God in dreams. And the stories in the New Testament talk about hearing from God through the Holy Spirit. Whether it's nature, other people, dreams, the Bible, God speaks to us all the time.
I guess you're right. God speaks to us all the time. But...
But what?
But even though God speaks to us, that still leaves us with one job to do.
What job is that?
To listen. If we don't listen to what God is telling us, then we'll be missing out like on so much.
Well, Cooper, you're absolutely right. Listening to God is one of the most important things we can do.
Well, you heard it, kids. Our big idea is step 3, listen to God. So on the count of 3, let's say it together. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, step 3, listen to God. Good job, everybody. Now next week, Cooper's gonna find out the last step in the super duper recipe book. So don't miss out, we'll see you then.
Wasn't that an incredible lesson about how Cooper can and how we can listen to God at every moment? I don't know about you, but sometimes I often forget that God is speaking all the time and how we should listen. I mean, let me ask you a question. Have you ever been around someone cooking popcorn? How do you know when the popcorn is done? You see, you hear lots and lots of popping, and then the popping slows down until you hear about one pop every few seconds. But see, it's super important to listen carefully. If you get distracted and stop paying attention to the slowing of the pops, what happens? It overcooks and burns. That means you have missed the timing. But see, paying attention to the popcorn popping is similar how we need to pay attention to what God has to say to us. Otherwise, we might miss it completely. You see, tuning into what God wants to say to you each day is so much better than just popping in every now and then. So every day this week, let's make it a point not to forget step 3, listen to God. You know, sometimes we need to hear God speak to us multiple times before we can really listen. No matter how many times it takes, what's our big idea? Listen to step 3, listen to God. You know, I love the wisdom that God gives us through his book in Proverbs. In fact, in Proverbs chapter 2, Proverbs 2, 1 through 5, it says this right here. It says, "My son, if you accept my words and store up my commands within you, turning your ear to wisdom and applying your heart to understanding, indeed, if you call out for insight and cry out for understanding, and if you look for it as silver and search for it as it is hidden treasure, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and the knowledge of God." You know, reading the Bible is one of the ways that we can listen to God because it is literally God's word. But you may be still wondering, how do I do this? But here's a simple way to take what God says in the Bible and turn it into a more meaningful time of listening to God. First, read God's words out loud. Ask yourself this question right here. What does the verse say? Then second, think about what God's words could mean. What is it saying to you? How is it connecting with you? Then the third is pray about what you just heard. What can you say to God about what you just read and thought about? You know, like verse 3, it says, call out for insight and cry out for understanding. Fourth, listen longer. Look at the words for a longer time than you normally would. Look for God in it. Just like it says in verse 5, it says, if you would look for it as silver and search for it as hidden treasure, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. You see, Jesus obeyed and listened to God until the very end, and we can do the same. Let me pray for you and ask God to help us listen to Him and His word more this week. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank you so much. I thank you that your word, that God's word is the best word. And I thank you that we can hear your voice all the way through this word. God, I pray that you would help us understand this. God, I pray that as we read Proverbs 2, God, that we would listen for understanding. We would cry out, God. We would say, God, what are you trying to say to us? And God, I pray that you would speak to us through your word as you have done to every person that's mentioned in the Bible. God, we love you and we thank you. And in your name, amen. Man, isn't that an incredible moment to listen to God? I don't know about you, but sometimes I forget that listening is just as much as important as talking to God. And sometimes I forget that listening is something that we always need to do to allow God to speak to us in our own ways. I don't know about you, but sometimes I feel like I forget to listen or forget to do stuff. And one of the greatest ways we can listen, remember, is through prayer, but also listening to God's word and following what he says. Sadly, it is time to go, but don't worry. We're going to be back next time as we pile all of these recipes together and we have a deeper relationship with God. In the meantime, have a great week and have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.